إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided. And he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jal can guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon Sayyidina Muhammad, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. The best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في القرآن الكريم said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه يسعى نورهم بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا. الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم telling us about a scene in the hereafter that a result of something that we do that Allah is asking us to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to make tawbah, tawbah to Allah. And why? Because we are carrying sins. That's kull ibn Adam khata. Every son of Adam commits sins. Khata makes akhta. Wa khayru al-khata'in at-tawwabun. And the best of those who commit sins are those who repent. So it is known and it is a fact that we commit sins. Some of us commit sins that are huge and some little ones or little sins, small mistakes or disobedience, and some big sins. But whether it is small or big, it needs repentance. There is no big sin that will stay with repentance. Repentance will take the big sins away. But there is no small sin with insistence. Meaning if we insist on the small sin, these small sins will be dealt with as a big sin. Meaning it has to be dealt with. It has to be forgiven through our repentance. And tawbah, in Arabic meaning, that has the meaning of raja'ah, meaning coming back or going back. So repentance meaning you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You go back to submit to Allah and admit our sins and ask Allah to forgive us and have intention and determination not to go back to it. So going back to Allah is a must for our sins to be forgiven. So tubu ila Allah tawbatan nasuha. Make tawbah to Allah that is sincere. Tawbah that it is from the heart. That is, you are conscious that you are making tawbah. You're admitting what you have done was wrong and worthy of being punished. The sincerity has to be in it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Asa. May Allah, may your Lord. And when this word is said with a human being, meaning that we can say, I will go such and such place hoping this I will do. Truly I am hoping, but I have no hand in executing what I really want to do. But hoping that this would happen, I'll be able to do it. Because it's not in my hand. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word hope and wishes and so forth, it means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do so. It does not mean perhaps as we use it as perhaps maybe this and maybe that. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do so. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do? Forgives your sin. Enter you into Jannat, into paradise, under which rivers are flowing. The day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us, take us to Jannah, and the day when we will see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and those who are with him. And those who are with him. الَّذِينَ مَعَ Meaning those who are worthy to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That their light will be in front of them and in their right hand, in their right. And they will say, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَأَتْمِمْ لَنَا نُورَنَا That, oh Allah, forgive us and complete our light for us. إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ You are capable over everything, Ya Allah. So here is repentance. The reward for it is so huge. Being with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned after repentance. Forgiveness and paradise is mentioned after repentance. Light between your hands in front of you is after repentance. And one must be clear of sins before they will be qualified to enter Jannah. Because no one will enter Jannah unless everything is paid for in whatever means. Through calamities, through sickness, or through repentance, through tawbah and raja'a lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إن الله يبسط يده. That Allah stretches His hand بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل. So those who commit sins at night will repent in the day. ويبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار. That then Allah will stretch His hand in at night, so those who commit sins in the morning will ask for repentance. Of course, when we start talking like that, when we hear that hadith like that, like meaning we're saying the hand of Allah and stretching and so forth, it should not, no image should arrive to our mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different than anything we can ever think of. ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing like Allah. وهو السميع المصير. And He's all hearing and all seeing. Meaning that these words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses and for us to understand, but how, when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the how is not known. But the action is known. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that once you commit a sin in the day, quickly that night repent. When you commit a sin at night, quickly repent in the day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quickly coming to you so you can cleanse and clean yourself quickly before the time comes and the soul comes out. Before the time comes and the heart becomes rusted, if you will, or ran will be on it. As in the hadith Rasulullah, in the meaning of which that tell us that the heart will have a dark spot because of the sins that one commit. And if one waits and waits, that darkness will overwhelm the heart, then the rust, if you will, or the ran will be over the heart. Repentance is an action that needs to come soon after the sin, so the heart will immediately be cleansed. Because if it is not, then we could easily fall into another sin because our strength will be weakened with the sins that's before. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us and encourages us to repent, to come back to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us in a way that we see it very quick and very often. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say day and night, right? My hand is stretched for you during the day, for those who commit sins at night. And the other way around, meaning quickly come back. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hadith al-Qudsi, famous hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yanzilu ila sama'i dunya, ila sama'i dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the lower skies every night. And again, when we hear the word coming down to lower sky, these are places and the movement. Again, we do not think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as some movement as we know it. ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing like Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down with a way, in a way that is befitting His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He asks, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down and asks. So now the matter is urgent because it is every night. See, every night. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you that if you sin, come back. I'm there every night for you. For you, who are you? For the one who knows this and take an action toward it. The one who's supplicating. Okay? The one that making dua. فَاسْتَجِبْ لَهُ. So I can respond to his dua. So, or for the one who's asking for something. Dua meaning supplication, whatever supplication. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for those who supplicate, I will respond to him. And for those who ask, فَأَطِيَ. So I will give him. Okay? And those who seek refuge, those who seek refuge with Allah, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him refuge. So if you are making, if you are committing a sin, okay, you go back to Allah, you ask Allah to forgive, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sin. You're making dua for something that you want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to your dua. Okay? You are in a problem, in a bind, in difficulties, and you're seeking refuge with Allah, Allah will grant refuge for you. Again, it is every night. We cannot wait for we're not going back to Allah. What is the fruit of all of this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran al-Kareem said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are seeking repentance, those who seeking refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are purifying themselves, meaning purifying spiritually, meaning their heart, and purifying themselves physically, clean. That is the fruit. The fruit is, do you reach the level that Allah will love you? This action of tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. This is a tool to get into among those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, أَنَا عِنْدَ حُسْنِ ظَنَّ عَبْدِي بِي. I am what my servant think of me. Okay? So, فَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي. And if he mentions me, if he remembers me within himself, I will remember him in myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying. وَإِذَا ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَأٍ. And if he mentioned me within a group, ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَأٍ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. That I will mention him in a group that is better than them. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I will mention you with the angels. See, when you repent, when one repents and in their heart they are connected with Allah, they are sincere and they are repenting, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention us. And if we make in dhikr, meaning remembering Allah and talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiving, the one who is al-ghafoor, al-raheem, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention us among the angels. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again give us this distance, these words that has distance in it. And then my servant, إِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ شِبْرٌ, if he comes to me with a hand span, تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا. وإذا تقرب إلي ذراع تقربت إليه باع. وإذا جاءني ماشيا جئته هرولا. And if he comes to me a hand span of a distance, a small distance, I will come to him an arm of a distance. And if he comes to me an arm of a distance, I will come to him is bigger than an arm of a distance. And if he comes to me walking, I will come to him running. See how beautiful this is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all these words talking to us about time, about space, about repentance, about hurrying up, about encouraging us to come close. And if you're too lazy to come and you come in a little bit, Allah will come a bigger distance. So when you walk to Allah, Allah will run to you. What does that mean? That means the distance will be shortened and the time will be shortened quickly. Why? Is it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislike us? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to forgive us. Listen to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to forgive us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not do any benefit. There is no benefit to Allah in punishing us. There is no benefit that we can give to Allah whatsoever. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to... He loves for us to repent so can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes this in a hadith. Okay? And again, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used the word love. Okay? When someone comes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, repents and goes back to Allah. Okay? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah is happy. No, the word in this hadith is not hub, it is farah. Yafrahu Allah. Allah becomes happy. And again, when we describe these words, Allah becomes happy in a way that is befitting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is happy when His servant comes back to Him. Okay? Now when you're going back to Allah, you should be happy. You're going back to Allah. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah is happy when you start coming to Him. More happy than a man who is in the desert. رَجُلٌ فِي فَلَا A man is in an open space in فِي فَلَا And he has an animal, has on the animal his food, everything that he needs. Then the animal runs away. Now he is waiting for death, meaning he cannot do for himself. But there is no way that he can have any help at this moment. So as he's staying, waiting under a tree, then he opens his eyes and hears his camel or his horse is there. Then he becomes very happy, so happy, okay? And he says, Oh Allah, you are my servant and I'm your Lord. Meaning, mistakenly, because of his happiness, saying something the opposite, say a word that he should not be saying. But it's understood that it's because of his happiness. Now imagine someone who is about to die, okay? And now all of a sudden he sees his food is back, and now he has this happiness, this joy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa describes that Allah is more happy for his servant to come back to him than this happy, than this man, happiness for the food to come back to him, and his animal to come back to him, for his hope for existence to be revived again, for hope for living to come back again. Just enough that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions repentance, He mentions Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are with Him in the Day of Judgment. That is enough. Enough incentive for us to say, yes, we will go back to Allah. We will repent. And repentance, it should be for what we know, from what we know and what we do not know. In sometimes when we sit and reflect about our lives, we think about issues that happened in the past that we did not realize it was a mistake that we have done until today. See, we grew up in getting to know what Islam is, grew up in the haram and what's haram, what's halal, what is lawful and unlawful and so forth, and behavior and all of that. So there are, maybe today we are, you know, committing sins yesterdays and nearby months and years, and we don't quite know that we have done so. So we need to ask Allah to forgive the sins that we know and the ones that we do not know. After all, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar, ask Allah for forgiveness. In Bukhari, Sahih Bukhari, 70 times a day. And in Sahih Muslim, 100 times a day. And who is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The one that he did not carry any sins with him. The one that is being protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked for forgiveness, when did he do so? All the time. As soon as he finished prayer. Now you imagine that would be the last, the least moment that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would remember forgiveness. Why? Because he just prayed to Allah. He was just standing and you know, performing the prayer. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remembers to make istighfar, ask Allah for forgiveness at that moment to show us that these are, do not think that you because you prayed, because you've done this, because you give charity, because of this and that, now you are forgiven. No. No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at this moment of finishing, after finishing the prayer, he asked, he says, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And that's what we do after prayer. So some scholars reflect on that. They say, see, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Allah to forgive him. Why? Because it is impossible for one to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what Allah deserves in appreciation and thanks. So no matter what we do, it is not enough to thank Allah for the bounty that Allah has given us. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Allah to forgive him for the prayer that he had done that does not serve what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves in thanks and appreciation. See? See now, so when we hear that, when we get to know that, now we're going to be in a different level asking for forgiveness. Not for a sin, for our disabilities of doing what we should be doing. It's not just for the sins that we committed. We are, you know, we have to move in different levels of repentance, or different level of what we are repenting from. As Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, some of us will be committing a small sin, and it will be like a mountain of Uhud on one's shoulder. Meaning it is so huge, but it's a small sin. Why? Because he is sensitive, okay, with the relationship with Allah. Okay? He's very sensitive, so something very small, it will seem to be so big. But some of us will commit a big sin, and it will be like a fly on our nose, and we just move our hand for it to fly away. Meaning the scale that we are using to measure our sin is a scale that is so dull and does not register unless you get a ton of sins on it. We need to move from that to a high level of thinking. When one thinks about the sin, one makes istighfar. When one heart think bad about something or someone, then when we repent to Allah. When one goes to sleep at night, make sure that the repentance is there. Because we know that our soul are lifted and taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during at night. Night is part of death. And when our soul is with Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, then he will keep the one he wishes to keep and send the other back. That's when one doesn't wake up or wakes up. So we should be aware of this as we are putting our head on the bed at night, that we might not be able to, no, we will wake up, but where are we going to wake up? Are we going to wake up and continue this lower existence, or we're going to wake up with the angel of death on our head, give us either a glad tidings of good news of what awaits for us, or giving us a bad news of what awaits against us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from among those who are tawwabun. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فادعوه يستجب. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين ما بعد. At the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a companion came, Ma'ad radiallahu anhu, and came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is starting mentioning a sin that he committed, and he's asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to أن يقيم الحد عليه, to perform the had, the penalty on him. When Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم realized what he's starting to say, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم turned away from him, didn't want to hear what he was saying, meaning it's better for him to go back and make a step far. He does not have to come and admit and so forth. But he insisted, kept coming back, until he committed, until he admitted that he committed zina. And he was muhsan, he was married, meaning the penalty for him is death. And he was executed as a had for the zina. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith that is sahih, two mentioning. Two narration. One, that he is now in the rivers of paradise swimming in it. And in another narration, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said that he repented and asked Allah to forgive him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him enough forgiveness that if it is divided among a nation, it would be enough for them. Here is a sin, but the forgiveness is with giving in abundance. So it doesn't, we should not look at how big the sin is, but we look at how greatness the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. But again, the sin, the repentance has to have quality in it. The quality of knowing that we committed a sin, the quality of sincerity of not going back to it, the quality of coming and asking, not taking for granted that saying Allah is al-Ghafoor al-Rahim and not going back to Allah. Allah is the most forgiving, but I'm not going to ask for forgiveness. No, the admission and the asking has to be there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the heart that is sensitive, so we become sensitive with the smallest sin that we commit.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the wisdom and the energy and the way to go back to Allah immediately after we commit whatever sins that we commit.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sin.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the right path.
Amen.
And help us to go on it.
Amen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us the wrong path and help us to stay away from it.
Amen.
Allahumma anta a'lamu bima fi qulubina faghfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma anta a'lamu bihajatina minna faqdiha lana. اللهم أنت أعلم بسرنا وعلانيتنا فتقبل معذرتنا. اللهم اجعل لنا إيمانا صادقا في قلوبنا حتى نعلم أنه لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتبته لنا.
آمين.
ولا ننال إلا ما كتبته لنا.
آمين.
وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وقوموا بصلاتكم ورحمة الله.